boy?
Mr. Bunker.
How you doing, sir?
Good. About yourself?
Good. Come on in. And how will these come out?
I have no idea. I've never tried it with pictures, honestly.
All right.
But they should come out pretty deep, and it's high def.
You so. Got a limit on how many of these you can do? All right. See, I don't.
I'm
computer illiterate, Mr. Maiden, so don't beat me up or laugh at me.
Nah, I'm just videoing them now.
There's my stepbrother. It was funny. The beginning of the Black Velvet collection. Who knew that it would... Who knew that 60 or 70 bottles would grow to 3 to 4,000? Hello.
Hello, yeah.
This was just some hoes that me and Tony picked up. Those there. Let's see. Those are guys I worked with at Sun Country.
Oh, yeah.
Mr. Maiden.
Hey, that is me.
That's with the fondue pot.
Oh, yeah. I remember you guys throwing bologna at me one night trying to make me eat.
Oh, I imagine you weren't doing meat back then.
Yes.
I think that's meat you're pretending to have in your mouth right there is what that is.
Yeah, there's Mr. Krasno.
That's what I bought for me when I was a tidy car for a day. There's Gina and Sharon.
Yep, Gina and Sharon. And,
much younger Jimmy Carlson.
Yes, it was. Who still lives in the same place, right?
Yeah.
Oh, the old bunker place. Hey, I still have the thing that used to go in your... I still have that picture.
What is it?
It was a D.O. thing that I made out of wax.
Sweet.
When I was in 12th grade.
And really?
You had it for the longest time.
No shit, you got it back?
Yeah, cool. I did get it back.
Cool.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
That's AJ there. AJ got
all right. AJ did.
No. And let's see what we got, dude.
Oh, there's the puppy. Lots of the puppy.
All right. There's Ori. And another shot of Dave with Bob. Excuse me.
Oh, look at Bunker. He's a party wild man. Bunker and Maiden. Them guys were probably wasted at that time. Okay, now I'm looking at this picture and I'm going, definitely Bob was wasted at that time.
You think?
Well,
what makes you think that?
I do see a drink in his hand. If I can see close enough, I'll bet you his eyes are red. Bunker and the pup. Oh, there's Mom. And the panther.
Will you do these so I can? Can you send these to me? I don't know how that works.
Yeah.
Sweet. Yeah.
I can either send them to you. I did a lot of this as just video. I started and I was like, yeah, screw the picture thing. I'll just make it a video. It'll be easier. Hell yeah, that old place. And the great.
I don't know what you want to get. Just if you're just chasing people, I'm not. I don't know. Hold on then.
Yeah.
You know what I want. Do that!
I got memories of running through that place quite a few times. Usually at nighttime for some reason.
Really? Oh, here we go. This was actually the cool shot of Bob I took out and I never put it back. But we got one there that the picture got all fucked up and Bob ended up with fucking light going through. It looked like he was being impaled.
I got some like that from, there's Mr. Rick and...
Rick and Tina and, oh shit. I can't think of her fucking name.
Murray?
No, it'll come to me. I can't get it.
Is it Mark?
That's Mark?
That is Mark. Cool thing is this camera is actually lighting up that picture where it was dark. Mr. Bunker and Sharon.
We got Denny, and then Bob, and then Bob and Dave Clark.
Wait a minute, where was this? No, that's not the bricks that we painted.
Yes, it is.
Is it?
Yes, it is.
In your hallway?
No, this was in the basement in Clio.
Oh,
we had that black screen and we painted bricks on all that.
Yes. Yep. Because then we did the ones in, we painted those pieces of paper and tacked them all up to the hallway and,
Yeah.
And it was leaves.
We did some creative things the week before Halloween. So to me, it's kind of funny that you are here and we were doing this the week before Halloween. Thank you, sir.
We threw all them leaves on the floor and cobwebs all over the place.
Wilson, Ron Gillian. He doesn't show up real well, but oh shit, not with us any longer.
Ray Springer?
No, I'm having a fucking memory loss. I can't think. Just lived two blocks away. Died over here on the Pier Road.
Oh
shit. Anyways, he grew up on. He lived on Pearson, the other side of Branch on the left. Him and his ma. His friend is Ronnie. It'll come to me in a while.
Yeah.
Anyway. What are you grinning about?
Rex carrying, Rex carrying a tree.
Yeah, he's got a tree.
He's got a ring of pine tree in his mouth.
I brought this dog home from Sherry's house out, Mark's sister's. Brought him home a piece of ass. I was drunk and I brought him home something and they made pups. Thank you, Dad. Rick Martin.
Oh, yeah. I've never seen his boy.
He's got two. He's got Ricky and Jeremy. That's Ricky there. Now, this is funny because Ricky's just graduated high school and he's a big guy now.
Wow.
Who's that one? That one there I'd like.
Oh, yeah.
I like that. It's got Rick, a happy Rick, and a little bit of Bunker character. Everything you see in all these pictures is in storage. I haven't seen it in forever. It's Kevin Doyle, Graham, Tina, Rick.
What in the world was Rick doing?
We were shaved his head. We were just getting ready to shave his head. He lost the bet. Bunker won the bet.
Oh, my.
Shaved his head.
Do we have an after picture?
No. Oh, I had one once upon a time, but he made me get rid of it. Here's Jeannie and Bob. Good picture of them. And then you and Ty.
Oh, yeah. Ty has aged well, too.
Yes, he has.
You don't look like he's gained much. What the hell is wrong? I was wasted.
You think?
It was a common occurrence over at Bunkers.
That's Janet's boyfriend, Chad Trout.
Yes, I remember that. Whatever happened to Janet?
I don't know. I would love to know that. That'd be interesting to know.
I couldn't remember her last name.
Dillingham.
That's it. Dillingham. Yes, I knew it was something English.
But she married Dennis Swanson, and then they divorced. They moved down to Indiana. He was a recruiter for the Marines or Navy or something.
Okay.
And then they divorced. I don't know. I don't know nothing past that.
There's my mom.
Get these two. We had gone on a fishing trip up north.
Yeah, I wish I could have got a hold of Rick. It'd have been good to have him there. I don't know if he has a Facebook. Huh, there's Marky. Is that a trip up north, Dave?
That's a trip up north.
Yeah.
Yeah. The dog took off through the woods and got hit with porcupine quills.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that ain't fun.
Yeah, it was funny.
mark.
Then when we went to try to find help, we lost the campsite in the truck, so we're on foot, found the dog, pork to my clothes, couldn't find the campsite. Oh my God. that was crazy. Going to Indianapolis Union Station.
Mm-hmm.
Union Station. Irene. Remember Irene?
Yeah.
I think that might be a wrap on that.
Hey, hold on. That was the old store, wasn't it? Canton, Ohio? The pink stuff in the background? Yep, sure was.
Yep.
Yeah. Canton, Ohio, man.
No. No.
Isn't it?
That's the inline store in Union Station.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's the inline store. Yeah, Union Station.
Did Fred have something with pink or what?
I don't know. He had that mauve carpet. He had the coolest carpet in Canton, Ohio.
Oh, I know.
Padding that fucking thick. Stepping in, you knew it was going to be expensive.
Technically, I ordered that carpet.
I thought you did.
I didn't know the difference. Is like, do you want 6 pound? Or I'm like, can you give me something that's really comfortable to stand on for a bunch of time? And they're like, well, we have something that's 20, 23 pounds. Student
paper just for Jeff. Hit this page up.
Now, who's this?
Somebody in Indianapolis. Okay.
So I was going to say, that can't be Tony.
No, that's Wayne Bryant from Indianapolis. I went down there listening to Slayer and left listening to Too Short.
Oh, no.
This guy made me go to jail in Indianapolis. This was all...
Hey, I know that IROC. That was Fred's IROC.
I wasn't driving presently. He was, but... Fred went to Florida for 2 weeks and left me the house and the car in the store. It was for the NCAA championship cross street at Hoosier Dome, and we couldn't sell no fucking jewelry, so I had this brilliant idea. We were going to get a whole bunch t-shirts. I hit Fred up. I said, hey, can I buy a bunch of t-shirts from fucking Walmart? Some. We fucking made like $15,000 selling t-shirts at Walmart. Fred was ecstatic. He kept pumping for it. You still selling t-shirts? Dude, I think like 600 sold fucking. He was just ecstatic. Anyways.
He had such a nice car and he kept it so trashed out.
Greenfield.
Oh, yeah. That is the place.
That is the place.
I don't even have a picture of that place.
You do now.
Yeah.
And I don't remember if these were friends of yours or if they were people I met there, but I took these guys to a Motley Crue concert in Ohio.
I know him, but I can't remember his name.
But I don't remember their name either, but that was him and his girlfriend. We went to a Motley Crue concert somewhere north of Canton in Ohio, some big stadium. But I don't remember how I met them, so I assumed that they were somebody you had met and introduced me to, but I don't know that to be for sure. In Bunker Jewelry School. Do me a favor. Hit these two up, too, because this bugger in jewelry school.
Yeah. I remember when you went down and did that. Sit down in Kentucky.
That was Louisville, Kentucky.
This
dude was from Charleston, West Virginia. Tried to get me to go back to Charleston, West Virginia with him, and this was a serious drunk fest.
All right. Well, jewelers, you know, they all got scales.
That dude was well-to-do. His parents owned a whole bunch of jewelry stores. I think that's going to be, for the most part, a wrap, Dave.
Okay.